Friends, this is your physics lecture taught by Tade Madam. In this videos, we see Kirchhoff's laws example, the concept as well as its example, and whatever the example I covered in this video is of the JEE Main 2019 as well as JEE Main January 2020. So I will assure you one question, compulsory one question from this topic will be asked for your JEE as well as NEET exam. Okay. आपको ये वीडियो अच्छा लगा तो लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब करना मत भूलिए। किर्चॉफ्स लॉज। सो फर्स्ट किर्चॉफ्स लॉ इज द केसीएल, किर्चॉफ्स करंट लॉ, इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ जंक्शन लॉ। सो दिस लॉ इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्ज। रिमेंबर दिस क्वेश्चन एज इट इज कैन बी आस्क फॉर जेई नीट एज वेल एज सीईटी। ओके, सो द किर्चॉफ फर्स्ट लॉ इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्ज। सो वॉट इज द केसीएल? जस्ट सिंपली यू कैन रिमेंबर whatever the current, incoming current to the junction is equal to current out through the junction. Okay, incoming current equal to outgoing current to the junction. So whatever this one is a junction, whenever multiple branches will meet at one point, we call it as a junction. Okay, so current, incoming current to the junction, here current I1 is incoming, so I1 plus, second I3 is also in, so I3 equal to current out. Who is out? I2. Out, I2 is flowing outward to the junction, and I4. So this is how we use the Kirchhoff's first law. Second Kirchhoff's second KVL, voltage law, it is also called as a loop law, and this is based on the conservation of energy. Okay, so here just you have to remember whatever the summation of E is equal to summation of IR. EMF is equal to whatever the terminal potential or potential drop across the resistor in the circuit is same. Conservation of principle, conservation of energy. So here you have, you can remember some data, some notation which we use for example. Consider this one is a resistor, and consider I will name this as A and B terminal. Okay. If the current is in this direction, current is in this direction, what is the drop according to Ohm's law? I into R is the voltage drop across the wave. And we know the current always flow from higher terminal to lower terminal. Okay. Now, if this is the direction of current and we are going in the same direction of the current, then in this case, we write VA minus VB is equal to IR positive. Okay. Now, if this one is the same condition and if we are going opposite to the current direction, opposite to the current direction, we write VA minus VB is equal to minus IR. Just remember this. Okay, the same theorem will be applied for the capacitor also. Consider A, consider B. This one is the current direction, the first having the positive charge, second having the negative charge. And if you are going in the same direction, whatever the terminal potential or potential difference across the capacitor is charge upon capacitor Q by C. Okay, V is equal to Q by C. This is positive when the current and this direction will be same. When it is opposite, this will be negative. QC minus Q by C. Okay, so the same theorem you can apply for EMF also. If EMF is this one and direction of current is this one, you are going in the same direction of current, then terminal potential you can write plus E, plus E. If you are going in opposite direction, you can write minus E. Okay, so you can remember in this way also. So from this we can solve some example. This one is a NEET 2017 and very simple example. 1 ohm, so here when the drop, this one is the current, 1 ampere is flowing, drop is current into resistance, 10 into 1, 10 volt is drop. Okay, apply. VA minus VB is equal to first positive to negative in the same direction we are going, current direction we are moving. So first positive 10, current direction positive 10, current direction positive 20. So whatever this one, 40 volt is the answer. Okay, similarly here we find VG minus VH. VG minus VH. Okay, so first this current is given. When the current will be passed through the resistor, there will be potential drop, 4 into 2, 8 volt will be drop. Okay, so this one is a direction of current and here the terminal is opposite. Remember here also how much current will flow, 2 ampere. So what is the drop? 2 into 2, 4 volt. So here we get 2 ampere current. Now here see, this one is 1 ampere, here 3 ampere, they are outward. Okay, they are outward. So to the junction, 1 plus 3, 4 ampere current should go. Okay, to balance this. Okay, to balance them according to KCL. So 4 ampere is here. This one is another junction. 2 ampere is incoming towards the junction. 4 ampere outgoing means through this branch another 2 ampere should go. Okay, should income or should be coming through the junction. Now, when the 2 ampere will flow from this, what is the potential drop? 2 volt. Now you can find Vg minus Vh is equal to first positive negative in the same direction we are going. So it is 8 opposite direction minus 3 same direction plus 4. Next here the current is in this direction and we are moving opposite direction. So it is minus 2 volt whatever the addition. 8 minus 3 5 plus 4 9 minus 2, that is 7 volt is the potential difference. Okay, so this is how you can solve. Next, so this one is another question as for JEE Main 2020. Okay, see, question is very simple, just you have to correctly solve the question. Okay, so the current I1 milliampere flowing through 1 ohm resistor in the following circuit. So what we have to find, what the current I1 we have to find. Okay, so I1 is here, meaning milliampere the current is starts flowing. Okay, so first we find what is the total current I flowing through the circuit. So first for that, what we have to do, we have to find equivalent resistance. Here these two connections are parallel, parallel 1/1 plus 1/1, that is it is 1/2. You can write 0.5. So it is 0.5 ohm. 0.5 ohm and 2 ohm are in series connection. So whatever equivalent of these two resistance series is 2.4. 2 ohm and 2.5 ohm are parallel. So what is the equivalent? Equivalent is 2 and 2.5 are parallel. So it is 2 plus 2.5, that is 4.5. Same decimal cancel. 5 5s are 5 9s are. Okay, so it is 10/9 resistance. Now we can find current. What is the current? V by R equivalent. V is 1 volt, R equivalent is 10/9, right? So it is 0.9 ampere is the current. So here whatever the current, 0.9 ampere will start flowing. 0.9 ampere will be start. Here is a junction, so current will be divided. Consider this as a current I. Consider this as a current I will write this as a I2 and this as I3. Okay, because here they are written I1, so I will consider I2. So this I2 current will be here. What is that? What is that? That we have to find. So how you find I2? Apply the current division rule. I2 is equal to whatever the opposite branch resistance to total current 0.9 divided by addition of both the resistance 2 plus 2.5, that is 4.5. Same decimal cancel, divide by 9, 9 5s are, so it is 2/5, that is 0.4. So I2, whatever the current through this branch is 0.4 ampere, right? Now, this 0.4 ampere will be divided here, but both the resistance value is same, so this will be equally divided. So what the I1 is 0.2 ampere. So whatever 0.2 ampere is the answer. Next. When the switch S in the circuit shown is closed, then the value of current will be. When the switch S is closed, what is the value of current I? Here is the current I they are given. Okay, this one is the direction of current I. This current we have to find. Now, when the circuit is closed like this, consider whatever the potential they are given A, B. First, we have to find C. So, consider potential at C is V. Okay. Now here apply first KCL. Consider junction C. Current I1 is incoming plus current I2 is incoming I2 equal to current I is out, so plus I. Okay. So whenever I is there, how we apply? We are written when the resistance is given, A terminal, B terminal. This is what the how the current will flow. R we write VA minus VB is equal to IR. Right. So what is I? I is equal to VA minus VB upon R, whatever this we apply here. So first current I1, this is how the direction of current is. So higher is 20 minus V divided by 2 ohm plus what the I2 is. I2 is in this direction. So potential B 10 minus potential V divided by, we consider potential at C terminal as V divided by resistance is R, equal to how the current I starts flowing from C junction to this. So potential at C V minus 0 grounded divided by 2. Okay, solve this. 20 by 2 is 10 minus V by 2 plus 10 by 4 minus V by 4 equal to V by 2. Take V one side. So it is 10 plus 10 by 4 is equal to V by 2 minus will be plus V by 4 plus V by 2. Okay, solve it. So this will be 50 by 4. This will be 5 V by 2 V by 2 V plus V by 4 5 V by 4 4 4 cancel, divide by 5, it will be 10. So what is V? V will be 10 volt, means whatever this potential is 10 volt. Now you can find current I. What the I is? V minus 0 by 2. What is V? 10, 10 by 2, that is the 5 ampere. So 5 ampere is the current through the that switch or that branch. Okay, next. In the circuit, the potential difference between A and B is potential difference between A and B. So whenever such EMF, they have given the EMF, you can consider E1, E2, E3. Okay, whenever such arrangement is given, first we can consider any current through this, and the current will be divided. Consider current I1, here current I2 will flow, here current I3 will flow. Okay, and whatever this one is the direction of current. Now here, using one formula, we can find this value. How we find? Consider VA minus VB, potential difference between A and B we have to find. And here, whatever the potential difference between V and B, VAB is nothing but potential difference between VDC. And whenever such arrangement is given, we can find a common potential difference of the such circuit. How we find? It is summation EMF divided by internal resistance divided by summation of 1 by R internal resistance. Okay, so how this we use? This we use as E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2, E2 by R2, like this. Okay, addition, and 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus, like this addition. Okay, so here we apply the same formula. So what is VDC? VDC is equal to summation E1 is 1, 1 by 1 plus E2 is 2, internal resistance 1, 2 by 1, 3 by 1 divided by resistance 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1. Okay, solve this. So 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. All the decimals are same. Add it. So this will be 2 volt. So 2 volt is the answer. So this is how you can solve. Okay. If you see carefully the next circuit, this is same as this one. Okay. Just I will rearrange the circuit. Consider here A. Here is the B. Okay. First R2. This one is the EMF. E2 is given. E2 is given. R2 is given. Next. A to B. Consider there is a resistance. Whatever these two resistors R1, R2 and these two resistors R1, R2 are series. So I can add 2R1, I can write 2R1. Okay. And they are given the values of all this. Just we can put the values. What they are given? R1 is given. R1 is 1 ohm. R1 is 1 ohm. So whatever R1 they are given as 1 ohm. Okay. R2 is 2 ohm. R2 is 2 ohm. Next, E1 is given. 2 volt. This one is 2 volt. E3, E2 and E3 are 4 volt. So these are 4 volt. So here R2 they have given 2 ohm. E2 is given 4 volt. Next, R1, this R1 series. So can I write 1 plus 1, 2? So here this one is 2 ohm directly you can write. And next, positive, negative. This one is negative. Okay. So this one is 2 volt. Similarly, you can arrange this one is also R1 plus R1, that is series, 1 plus 1, 2 ohm, this is also 2. So, there also E3 is given. So this E3 you can write 4 volt. Okay, so this one is E3. Now you can apply, you can find the common terminal potential between AB as summation of EMF upon internal resistance divided by summation of 1 by R. So what is E1? E1 is 2. E1 is 2 divided by internal resistance 2. E2 is 4 divided by 2. E3 is 4 divided by 2. Right? Divided 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2. Solve this, you will get the answer. So 1 by 2, 2, 2, I will, whatever this 2 take common, so it is 3 by 2, and this 2 take common, so it is 10 by 2. This 2 take, get cancelled, 10 by 3, solve this, whatever this one is, 3.3 volt. So 3.3 volt is the answer. In the figure, what is the current drawn from the battery given? R1 is given 15, R2 is given 10. R3 is given 20, R4 is given 5 ohm, R5 is given 25 ohm, R6 is given 30 ohm, E is given 15 volt. What we have to find? Current through the battery, current drawn from the battery. So this is how the current positive current will start flowing. That current we have to find. Okay. So to find the current, just we have to find equivalent resistance of the circuit. First we find equivalent resistance. When we see the equivalent resistance, whatever these three resistance, how they are connected in series, so we just add 25 plus 5, 30 plus 20, that is 50, right? This 50 and this 10, how they are connected parallel? So whatever these parallel connection, what the equivalent of this? 10 into 50, 10 plus 50, that is 60. So it is 50 by 6 or 25 by 3, 25 by 3 ohm. Now 15, 25, 3. Here we take this equivalent of this and 30. These are series. So what the R equivalent is? R equivalent is 15 plus 30 plus 25 by 3, which is nothing but 45 plus 25 by 3. You can multiply 15, 135, 25 divided by 3. Add it, 0, so it is 613. So what is the current? Current is nothing but V or E divided by equivalent resistance. V is given as 50, equivalent resistance 160, and divide by 3 will get numerator, divide by 5, 5 3s are, 5 3s are, and 5 2s are. So it is 3 into 3, 9 divided by 32 ampere, 9 by 32 ampere. Okay. So the questions are very simple, just you have to solve very carefully. Next, determine charge on capacitor. Determine charge on capacitor. Okay. So here you have to remember, when we connect the battery at t is equal to 0, whatever the charge on capacitor is 0. Okay, just we are connected the battery for charging of capacitor. Now when the charge is 0, current through the capacitor is 0. And when the current is 0, whatever this capacitor acts as open circuit, means whatever this branch will be open. This branch will be open. Okay, so consider now it is open. Only remaining resistances are present. Okay, first we have to find the equivalent resistance. Find equivalent resistance. I will draw again the diagram. This one is 6, 4, 2. So 10, 2, 4, 6, 72 volt. Find equivalent because this was open now. So 10 and 2 are series, so it is 12. This 12 ohm and this 4, they are parallel. So what the equivalent? 4 into 12 upon 4 plus 12 is 16. 4 4s are, 4 3s are. So this is 3 ohm. 6 and this 3, 6 and whatever these 3s are, this 3 is series, so 6 plus 3, 9 ohm. Now using this we can find current. What is the current? V by R equivalent, 72 by 9, that is 8 ampere. 8 ampere is the current flowing. So the 8 ampere here is whatever the current, 8 ampere. Here the current is 8 ampere. Now here is a junction and current will go divide. So how the current will divide? Here this resistance is 4 and whatever this combination is 2 and 12 series, so this is 12 ampere. So you can find current through any branch, you will get another. So here consider whatever this current as I1. So I will find I1. How you can find I1? It is the opposite resistance total current divided by addition of both the resistance. 12 plus 4, 16. 4 4s are 4 2s are. That means 2 ampere will flow in this circuit. Remaining 8 minus 2, 6 ampere will flow. Okay, or you can take the ratio 4 and 2, 12. It is the ratio 1:3. When the resistance is higher, current through that is lower. 12, 2 and 2 by 6. It is also 1:3 ratio. Okay, so logically also you can find this relation. Now 2 ampere current will start here, 2 ampere, right? So what the current is? The current will be 2 ampere here. Now when this current, whenever the time t is equal to 0, just we have connected the battery, at that time the current through the circuit is maximum, current through the capacitor is maximum. Now when the time will beyond 0, the capacitor starts charging and the potential difference will be increased across the capacitor. And what the potential difference across capacitor? We know it is the V is equal to charge upon capacitance, right? So what the charge is, what we have to find? We have to find charge. So what the charge is? Capacitance into potential difference. First we have to find potential difference. What the potential difference? This is terminal potential across this 10 ohm. So when 2 ampere will flow start through this, what the terminal potential? 10 into 2, 20 volt. 20 volt is the potential. So charge is 20 volt potential into 10 micro farad. So multiply this, this will be 200 micro coulomb is the charge. 200 micro coulomb is the charge. So just you have to remember whatever the initial. So whenever they have given this condition or they have defined the capacitor is in steady state, at that time you have to remember the current through the capacitor is zero and capacitor act as a open circuit. Next, in the given circuit, the current I1 is given. They have given different current. We just mark the current. In the given circuit, the current I1 is given minus 0.3 ampere. Minus 0.3 ampere means the direction of whatever the current they have given is opposite. Means the current is this one. 0.3 ampere current is given. Okay. In this direction, the current is actually directed. Next, I4 is given. I4 0.8. I5 is given 0.4. Okay. What we have to find? I2, I3, I6 respectively. Here we can apply the junction law, KCL, first loop, first Kirchhoff's law. We consider the junction S. So current I4 is incoming, I5 is out and I3 is also out. So use the junction law. Current, incoming current 0.8, outgoing 0.4 and also outgoing is I3. So what the I3 is? I3 is equal to 0.8 minus 0.4, that is 0.4 ampere. Means this one is 0.4 ampere, right? Now this I5, same current will be flow, just they have given the different name, but this I5 and I6 is remain same because whatever these resistance are series, this you have to remember and you have to solve correctly. So I6 is 0.4. If this one is 0.4, this one is also 0.4, and here the 0.3 is also coming. All the currents are incoming. So what we have to do? We have to add all incoming current, which is nothing but outgoing current. So what is I2? Addition of all 0.4, 0.4, 0.3. So can I write it is 1.1 ampere. So I2 is 1.1, I3 0.4, I6 0.4. So correct answer is